Austin, who won it all just last night. Again, we apologize for the remarks of last night from Brian Pillman, notwithstanding those as well of tonight.
You didn't even answer him.
Well, listen. Well, nonetheless, here comes the answer. Here comes the answer, yes, Stone Cold Steve Austin,
who won it all
at the King of the Ring. Now going one-on-one with a man I would suggest who's in a bad frame of mind. Yes, the greatest phenom in the history of the World Wrestling Federation, The Undertaker.
Maybe that's Mankind's title now.
And The Undertaker suffering a defeat at the hands of the maniacal Mankind. And unfortunately, Paul Bearer accidentally added to the demise of The Undertaker last night, attempting, I would suggest, to strike Mankind with the urn, unfortunately.
I don't think it was an accident.
What?
I don't think it was an accident.
The Undertaker, live in Green Bay, Wisconsin. They have jam-packed this arena, ladies and gentlemen, yes. The Undertaker bringing the lights up. And even a man who has ice water in his veins, like Stone Cold Steve Austin, must be feeling a little antsy. Stone Cold Steve Austin receiving some 16 stitches in his mouth, his lips split wide open, ladies and gentlemen, in the matchup with the Wild Man Marc Mero. Went to the emergency room, got stitched up, came back and defeated Jake the Snake Roberts, who likewise was having great physical difficulty in terms of rib injuries. Both men gallantly returning, and nonetheless, he was, look out for the high.
Yes. I'm gonna tell you, Stone Cold Steve Austin's as tough as me, McMahon. He may prove to be the most prolific king yet.
Oh, no!
The Undertaker, look at that look. The Undertaker with aggression like we have never seen before in The Undertaker just last night. And I'm lucky to see that we're gonna have The Undertaker with that same aggression. Look at this,
whoa.
Oh, and a shot there. The Undertaker hammering away on Stone Cold Steve Austin. Could very well split that mouth wide open again. Much like Wild Man Marc Mero did just last night.
Yeah, and Mero's gonna pay for that, McMahon. Oh! Not likely to be a lot of warmth in this match. You know what I'm gonna do? I'm gonna go up here and see if I can get a word with Paul Bearer. I'm gonna see exactly what happened last night.
Paul Bearer is busy. Oh, to the buckle! The Undertaker with Stone Cold Steve Austin. And what an unbelievable, it was guerrilla warfare last night with Mankind and The Undertaker.
Hey, listen,
it was
I want to ask you a couple of questions. What happened to you last night, Paul Bearer? Huh? Did you drink a little too much formaldehyde or something? Huh? Was your aim a little off? Come on, tell the people what happened. Huh? You're looking,
oh!
You must be proud of what you did. Your face looks a little ashen. Come on, tell me.
If the Undertaker sees what's going on behind him, he's going to come right after the king.
Come on, look right in there and tell us exactly what happened. Huh? What's in that urn anyway, huh? Folgers, crystals, or something? Come on, there it is right there. Speak to me.
And obviously, Paul Bearer feels badly enough over that unfortunate incident. Wait a minute, over in this side now. Look at that. Stone Cold Steve Austin pulling The Undertaker right out, rams him to the apron, hammers away on The Undertaker. Stone Cold Steve Austin with The Undertaker. Oh, no! Right into the ring post.
Did you hear that, McMahon? Huh?
We hear what?
I tried to get him to speak. He's speechless.
Embarrassed, obviously. to the steel steps.
How can somebody that looks like him be embarrassed by anything?
The Undertaker. We said before, likely to be in a bad frame of mind. You're just lucky The Undertaker didn't get his clutches on you.
Yeah.
The Undertaker will face Goldust. It definitely will be an international incident for sure in Vancouver, British Columbia, from Canada on July 21. And The Undertaker obviously has had problems with Goldust thanks to Mankind
In that casket match, who knows what's going to happen now?
That's right. The Undertaker, he's got to be sore. That's why he didn't come out and do anything to me, McMahon. After what Mankind did to The Undertaker, nobody has ever done to The Undertaker what Mankind has done to him.
Wild man Marc Mero. Oh, my goodness.
Right in his mouth, I think.
Really taking it to the limit. Just last night against Stone Cold Steve Austin, an unbelievable battle. Oh, my goodness, The Undertaker now. Oh, look at that. Kicking his way free from the clutches of Stone Cold Steve Austin.
Come on, McMahon, tell me, why do you think Paul Bearer wouldn't speak? Huh? Why didn't he try to explain his actions? Embarrassed?
You were attempting to humiliate him out there. Stone Cold Steve Austin may have had enough. Austin, who had so much taken out of him just last night. Austin, and receiving it in the headbutt.
That's a consummate athlete right there, McMahon, and a man worthy to be called king. Who else would receive an injury like he did, and then go to the hospital, have a surgeon sew your mouth up 16 stitches inside and out, and then tell him, get me off this table.
Yeah.
Put me back in that ambulance.
Take me back
to that arena, because I want to be the king of the ring.
He wanted to win it. It's all about competition here in the World Wrestling Federation. The Undertaker panning Stone Cold Steve Austin. Undertaker coming out to rope and no. Look at that, though. Undertaker sitting right up. The Undertaker more aggressive than ever. And Stone Cold Steve Austin with a right hand. You have to wonder, psychologically, just what that defeat, what that blemish on the record of The Undertaker will mean. Oh, my goodness.
Oh.
A boot to the midsection. The Undertaker ready to polish off Stone Cold, perhaps.
Let me go back up here.